I was managing some property for some people in Bloomington. And the lady says to me, "Golly, you take better care of this property than we do." I said, "Well, I work for you." She says, "What?" I said, "I work for Jesus." She goes, "Oh yeah, you're right. She's a Christian, you know." I said, "As long as I do my best for him, I don't really care if I please you or not. As long as I'm in his will, what he wants, you got a problem with that, it doesn't matter to me. It doesn't bother me at all." And you stick with it, okay? You stick with it. I stuck with it. Got a scholarship to college. But between then, senior year in high school, I became a Christian. Now, I was not a believer. I was a believer in God, you might say. I believed in God. But you see, there's a difference in believing in God and having a personal, daily relationship to God in Jesus Christ. There's a big difference. I call it the NB syndrome. You guys may not be familiar with Andy Griffith and NB.
Yeah.
But many of you are. You know who Aunt B is? Aunt B is on the Andy Griffith show. Okay? Well, Aunt B went to church every Sunday, sang in the choir, went to prayer meeting on Wednesday night. But when Aunt B ran up against a problem, she completely folded. She completely went bananas. She worried so bad she gets sick. Her life in church had nothing to do with her daily living. There were two separate worlds. That should not happen. You come to church. If you don't get it at church, then learn to call upon the Lord yourself. Learn to follow the scriptures yourself. Instead of having someone draw from the well and giving it to you, learn to draw from the well yourself. See, have a personal relationship to Christ. Just like you have a personal relationship to your sport, whatever. You want to be the best? Some of you had some pretty big dreams. I dare say that most of you will never reach the things that you talk about. Because most of you will not pay the price. And from what I heard in some of those things, it's going to take a big price. And you're not willing to pay it. Most people are not. To be the best at anything takes paying a price. You're not willing to pay the price. You're not going to be the best. Because there's somebody else going to be paying it bigger than you. Now, Jesus paid the price on the cross. And everything in this book, everything, there's nothing of importance in any of our lives outside of the cross. There isn't anything. You can argue with me all day long. I won a gold medal in the Olympics. Do you know how much this means in the kingdom of God? It means nothing. Absolutely zilch. Zero. It means absolutely nothing. So, don't put your faith in something like this. Put your faith in the one who died for you. Then, who knows? You might still have something like this. You just have it in the right perspective.